Yeah, right. Back to you, Padma.
Yeah. So the first thing, as we said, is going to be about the changes in the pattern. So as you all know, what has changed is basically the percentages across each section has not changed. English still continues to be 20%. The current affairs is still 25%, and the legal reasoning is also 25%. So they have been 25% in the past with 50-50 each, and even now they continue to be there. And logical reasoning again has 20%, and quantitative techniques will be 10%. So in the old pattern, we had the same percentages. Even today, after the changed pattern, your number of questions has changed. In fact, the number of questions, they have not kept it static in the sense that they have given a range instead of a fixed number of questions. So you might see, you know, there's a range like 28 to 32 in English and 35 to 39 in GK and legal reasoning. So it could be a little on the higher side, it could be on the lower end. So it all depends on, you know, how the overall structure they would like to retain, because most of it is passage based. So now when you have a passage based question, sometimes you might have 5 questions per passage, or there could be 6 or 7. So based on that, you have this variation. Okay. Now, having said that, what has not changed? The total number of questions has definitely changed, brought down from 200 to 150. So psychologically, that's a big, you know, positive thing for you, in the sense the number of questions are less. So you feel good about it, that you don't have to do 200 questions. You just have to do 150 questions. Now the time still remains 2 hours, though it's come down from 200 to 150, it is still 2 hours. So that way there's no change in terms of the time limit. There's no change in terms of the negative marking. You know that the same negative marking is there earlier also. And even now it's like, you know, 0.25, which will be deducted for every wrong answer. So you have to keep that in mind, and that has an impact. Accuracy has a very big impact on your overall score, not just for increasing your score, but also ensuring that there is no reduction in what in the score. You do a good work, and you know, if you do something wrong, you're going to come down that much. So you have to be conscious of that all the time. So that kind of thing, definitely you will have to keep in time. Other than that, what has changed is the focus from the concept or knowledge-based exam to a reasoning-based exam. So this is more of a skill-based exam. It is not a knowledge-based exam. Earlier also it was a skill-based exam, but here there was also some part of knowledge that was being tested. This year it's very less of knowledge, and it's entirely based on your skill you're going to be tested. And that is the reason why this last 1 month is going to be very critical for you in terms of honing your skill, in terms of, you know, tuning yourself, in terms of the last, you know, as you say, polish that you need to do to your preparation so that you can ace this exam. Naresh, do you want to add that?
Yeah, I think once again, and probably, you know, Srilata Patro seems to have said, happy to see both of us at the same time. You know, they get to see one of us. Okay, good. Sudh is asking how to enhance GK. We'll definitely talk about it, Sudh. Please wait for the GK sectional strategies. But meanwhile, overall, what I would want to say is, broadly, the exam has changed more skill, right? CLAT has always been a skill exam as compared to a medical or engineering exam. But having said that, with the change of multiple choice questions, single multiple choice questions, to a passage based multiple choice questions, I think the emphasis has become far greater on skill. And that's why this time we see that those who generally have good reading skill will do far better than those who have worked hard but do not really have great reading skill. So we cannot overemphasize the importance of reading. You keep reading. That's a fundamental thing I would want to say. And Padma, I would want to kind of, on this slide, I want to bring to the notice of all our students here one important thing. I believe this slide, more than anything else, timing, questions, like Padma said, is all good. But the bigger thing is you all need to kind of temper your cutoff planning. For example, when it was a pure MCQ-based exam, when it was 200 questions, 120 minutes, we have seen students have scored as high as 170 plus. All India toppers have scored 170 plus also. The top 10 rankers have scored 170 plus also. But I believe we have seen over the last 6 months now, it's almost 6 months now, one from the time we have seen the notification changes, etc. We believe a 120, 130 would be a great score out of 150. So just like 170 was possible in 200, I don't think 130 plus is so easily possible in 150. Anyone who is scoring 120 plus would be among the top rankers. And a score of 140 plus would have been considered a good score for the original pattern. I would say that number comes down to 100 now. So those who are targeting to kind of get into an NLU, you should at least be scoring 100. Those who are targeting to be in the top three NLUs, you should be scoring a 120. Target should be 120. That's one other important point I would say that you should keep in mind, right? Yeah, that is what I would want to say on this slide, Padma.
Okay. Coming to the overall strategy, what you need to keep in mind, as we know, always in CLAT exam, the time is a major issue. So time management is a major challenge that you all need to have in mind. You need to overcome this challenge and have a strategy for it. Strategy will be person dependent in the sense based on your skills in which area you are strong. But broadly, as we have always said at Abhyas Law Prep, you need to alternate your sections between those which need some work in terms of thinking or, you know, in terms of maybe doing some calculations versus those sections which have a lot more reading to do. Like, for instance, English, legal reasoning and logical reasoning have a lot more reading and thinking to be done. Whereas GK and quantitative techniques are sections where you're, to some extent, in these are the two areas where knowledge plays a role. In the sense that you need to know the formulae and the techniques of how to do the calculations fast in order to do QT well. And of course, GK is to a large extent present, dependent a lot more on knowledge as compared to skill. Skill definitely is important over there also. So yes, we will get to, you know, how to go about these things, and specifically more in GK, Naresh sir is going to add a lot more on that. But coming to this particular aspect in terms of time management, so that we just complete this topic and move on. Yes, Naresh.
No, I think to kind of broadly put together, we I think this is something that we have built upon in some of our earlier mock analysis of Padma. So I'm trying to kind of come in because I thought I want to bring to the notice of our students about what we have said earlier. Like you nicely put it, right? Alternating. The word nice word that you put is alternating. It's very important for you to kind of do these five sections in an alternating format. That is, those sections that require a huge reading comprehension skill, right? Sections which are focused very much on the passage, not so much on the questions, like your legal, like your logical, like your English, because the focus is definitely on the passage. Only for the passage do STEM questions follow. Whereas those sections like GK and mathematics, like Padma said, they're little knowledge oriented in the sense that the passage dependence is less as compared to questions. Questions are more important in a way. So you have to kind of interpret these things. That's what we are broadly saying. Whichever section you would want to start with, we are absolutely fine. But please ensure that you do not do these three sections, that is logical, legal, and English, all three of them simultaneously, because your mind also is a muscle, right? It kind of requires a kind of, you all have to have ebb and tide. We need to kind of ensure that we have a flow. So it is better to start with one of these areas and go to a GK, and then probably do another second area, then go to another area like that. That's the broad decision with respect to choice of sections. You can definitely have your own section, but I generally say GK has to be definitely done in the first half of the exam. Do not leave GK to the last half, because GK, you can do almost 35-40 questions in a span of 15 minutes, not more than 15 minutes. And that's why we want you to be doing it in the first 2 to 3 sections, particularly in the first 2 sections. At the same time, please don't do GK as the first section, at least in this year exam, like I have halved enough number of times already, because we need to kind of ensure GK is a kind of relief in some way for many of you in terms of your using your mind, etc. So use GK as a second section, do some other section, heavy section, then come to GK and then go to the next section, vice versa. Coming to the attempts, Padma, I mean, I'm just kind of taking a lead here and you can probably add later. See, attempts, as I told you, it's pretty important for you to know that out of the 150 questions, you would have around 30 passages, right? 25 to 30 passages on average. You would have 25 to 30 sets, if I have to say. Think of it, in 120 minutes, you have to do 25 sets or so.
Okay, I think there is a freeze. Can somebody tell me? Naresh, video is frozen. Okay, fine. I'll continue. I think what Naresh sir has been saying, there are going to be 30 sets. Don't worry, sir, we'll come back online. With respect to the attempts, there are going to be 30 sets that you will need to attempt. And you know, the out of the 30 sets, it is not going to be possible for you to answer all 30 sets. So don't get worked up if you're not able to answer all 30 sets, because 30 into 5, 150 questions. Let's look at this thing. So what happens is, throughout our you know, childhood, right from the beginning, we have this you know, thing grinded into our head all the time. Any question you go, don't leave anything. You have to attempt every question. If you write something, you will get at least one mark. Yes or no? You've been told this right from your childhood. Every single exam that you write, you've been told that, right? Yes or no? I'm not frozen. Sir will come back. Don't worry. Okay. So you will have this always at the back of your mind, that every single question I have to answer. But what happens is, in this competitive exams, that is not the way it works. Okay. In the competitive exams, what happens is, you are to make sure that your accuracy is also good. The more number of attempts you have, the, you know, the lesser the chances are also higher that you will make mistakes. So when you are in doubt, you should not answer. Make sure that out of this 150 questions, you are able to have as many number of attempts as you can do correctly. If you are having any, all your confident questions, definitely you will need to attempt. And at the most, you can attempt like, you know, 15 or so questions which are doubtful. If you are in doubt, you should not answer too many questions. And the questions where you are marking with a doubt also, you have to do some kind of an elimination process and some kind of what you call is, you know, your guesswork also has to be intelligent guessing. It cannot be a random guessing. In a regular exam where there is no negative mark, you will keep, you know, just doing leave out or you mark A, B, 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 B. It will not matter. But here is definitely going to matter, because you cannot keep doing that kind of a thing. Now, the question is, how do we decide which set to leave in case we are short of time? You need to, as we say, the overall strategy, you need to set us. Now, one, you will decide the order in which you will do the sets, right? Two, there are also, you know, or suggested timelines that we give for each section. We have discussed, and we'll also again discuss in a little while, the how much time to be allocated to each section. So within each section, what you should do is always, the first, let's say you have about 25 minutes for a section. The first 2 or 3 minutes, try to do a quick look at all the passages or sets that are there and quickly glance at the questions. Don't go too much into the depth at that stage. You're just trying to see, what is this passage all about? And then try to choose, okay, I will do some of, you know, all these questions I will do. Maybe this I will leave, that kind of thing. What is important is, within your time limit, don't look at the entire 2 hours as one, you know, chunk of time. You have to split your time according to the suggested time limits for each section. And when the time limit for your section, you decide on a section, your time limit is up, just do a hard stop, move on to the next section. Okay. Come back to it later if you have got time, and because you're not seeing that other sections, maybe you're not able to answer and you want to improve on this section, you can come back and then solve the questions that you have left out. But don't try, you start a section, don't try to complete that section and then only move on to the next section. So the cue for you to move on to the next section is when the time for that particular section is over. It comes to an end, you have to move on. So that's the way you will need to take it up and go forward. So Sheetal, I hope your question is answered. Which set, it will be different for each person, right? So another question.